Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I'm out here out in the woods finally. It's finally a good weather, and I'm going to camping for a solo camp. Well, that didn't sound right. A solo camp. Here's my gear. And a lot of people say, how you can carry so much? It's endurance. Your endurance is what gives you the power to do stuff. How much weight? And this is another video, a good shout out to Tom at Clickwood to show you, hey, look, I got my sheath on. And I got my saw blade. This is what I had for my saw. Let's put you right here. Bend down. All right, this was my case for my saw. You know how many times I had to go back in the woods to find this thing because it fell out of my this case? Ah, piece of shit! But I'm going to still use it. Now, I got this, the amazing time machine. He sewed, he dowed, he did a good job. Look at that. It fits right on. Ow, come back. It fits right on my case. Look at that. Look what I did. Sorry for the shakiness. This is what I did, and I took the little, see, at first I was pissed off. Oh man, look at this, it don't fit. But hey, that gives it a bite. So that's not gonna move nowheres. And what I did is took that little molly strap that he put on, went down, went through this loop, and buckled again. So I'm definitely not gonna lose my saw any which way. Look, it fits perfect on there. And it looks perfect with my gear, Tom. Look at that. Can anybody else do that? No, probably not. But it fits right on with my fanny pack, my water jug, and my saw in a little pouch of rope. Thank you, Tom. That's a big shout out to you. Now, I'm still going to use this little diggity thing for something else, maybe. Something that can fit in there and it's not going nowhere. But this is going to be my first solo camp. I do go camping, but I never record it. I don't know why. So I'm going to bring you out to the woods. I'm going to do record lessons real quick. Show you where I'm at. Where is this place? Some of you might know where this is. Some of you might not know where this is. So let's take a look in the woods. Find out where this is. Look at the view. It's wooded. Alright, let's take a look. Where are we going? Some of y'all might know where this is, like I said. But this is where my camping spot is. Well, I'm going to be camping tonight. It's in the jungle. Welcome to the jungle. Right here. And look, somebody already left me some 550 cord. See, we need to untie this to keep the tree alive. That's going to kill the tree. So loosen it up and retying it keeps the tree from going into that rope. So, oh shit, we got an ant pollen in our home. Oh, damn it. And I'm going to loosen this up. Well, this is the good tie. See that? That's loose. So you can always move that around. Keep that from killing your tree. But this is where I'm going to be camping at tonight. I know I got ants. I might put my hammock over here. Let's see. It looks pretty good. What y'all think? Alright. Well, I'm going to get my camping gear. And bring it over here, and I hope I don't get eaten by ants tonight. All right, let me let y'all go into the next part of this video. All right, see you in seconds. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I showed you something this morning, well, early just in the first part of this video, a back door. Who this back door belongs to, it's up to the person I'm going to review himself. And if you don't know this camping area by now, sorry for you. But I did some stuff here while I'm here. I added some more stuff to his camping area to make it more livable. I made him a bush chair and I made him a canopy. Come see what I did. Bam! I made him the bush chair and I put a canopy. I put the T. So when he could put his hammock here, he could put his tarp over this and have more room so he can have where he comes underneath. All right, this is the amazing bush chair. This is how I make my bush chair. There's different ways of making it. So, I'll show you what it's all about. And the person's back door, I better see you use your bush chair. All right. Basically, the bush chair has a little slot here and a little tie off up here. So what I'm going to do is take this off and slide my bush chair in the slot. Now it's going to take a few times to get it right. Now then you take your 550 cord that you tied to your bush chair and you tie it up here. All right, then like I said, it's going to take some time to get it right. You might have to raise one side, raise the other side, but this is the bush chair. I don't think you have to do nothing. It's perfect. There you go. This is the bush chair for this person's back door. And I made the canopy. So next time I see you out here, you better be with you in your bush chair, sir. Or I'm going to be pissed. Because I hate it. Oh, you want this? Yeah, I'll use it and never use it. This way, you have no other choice but to use your bush chair that I gave to you, my friend. I hope you enjoyed this one little crazy video of the bush chair. It's really low. The person might have to raise these up, figure this out. You can always bring this back. That's all I did is take three sticks. Well, it takes four sticks to complete and build. I made a, come here, you can't see shit. So I made a teepee. Now I made one long so I could put a light here. I could put a light here. I could put stuff here to light up my area where I'm eating, what I'm doing. I can hang stuff here. I can hang a pot here. You know, eat my food, let it hang. Everybody has a different style of making the bush chair. And you can raise these ropes if it's too low. And that's the amazing bush chair. Then I made the the T for him, both sides. So you can now look at this campsite. If you don't know whose campsite this is, I'm gonna let the person who owns this campsite say who it is. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky. And I decided not to stay out here because it's hot as a bitch. It took me a couple hours to build this because you do not overheat yourself out here in these woods and this environment. And this, I got this, and it goes on my bush chair for comfort and more warm during the winter. This is a winter part. I usually take that out. And my bush chair goes in a little small pouch. All right, so this all you do is take the bush chair off. Hang your wood. Never let your wood lay, get. Come back to me. All right, back where it was I said. All right, I'm gonna find a better system with this camera. It's a pain in the ass. All right, always take and hang your stick back up, because you don't want it to be on the ground. You've got to make it with some good oak, hardwood. All this is oak. It's white oak. And this is all got to be oak, and you got to strip this down so when you put your sleeve in, it won't tear it up. And what I do is just take my bush chair. When I'm rolling it up, place this back on, fold it in half, and roll my bush chair up. Now you can use net if it's more comfortable for you. I do use that during the summer. The net one is nothing but a hammock made with net, and I use that for my bush chair. Same principle, just have a rope and tie it on. All right, I want to end this video real quick. I'm Ranger Kooky, and that's the bush chair and the tee for those hammock lovers. And that's all I did, is do a little loop, so I can move this rope up and down, tie a tee, one's longer than the others. And that's it. I'm Ranger Kooky, and I hope you enjoy this crazy video. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I'm going to show what Donnie's coming up here. He thinks somebody's been back here destroying his campsite. But hey, I've been building all kinds of goodies for him. Look at the stuff I did for him. Now he's going to come back here, and I'm going to scare the hell out of him.
Camping in my spot. Dang, that looks pretty good. What in the world? Wow. That's pretty good. Good Lord. Do something. My mind must be playing tricks on me. I thought I heard something. It's the Kooky Monster.
You better watch out, because I'm going to eat your soul.
Wow. Man, Ranger Kooky.
This is Dolly Pollinati.
That's me all day long and half the night. Man, check that out. Good Lord, you've been working your butt off out here.
Yes, sir. I came out here to Donnie Pollinati's camping site.
You pimped it out.
And I pimped it out.
You ain't wrong.
I saw him. I saw his videos. I've been watching his videos. This is my second time out here. The first time was raining cats and dogs and elephants. So I went by his house to about 1 o'clock in the morning, I think, or 12.
Yeah. Something like that.
And we had a good time. We talked, and I built this for him today.
My gosh, look at that. Check that out. That's awesome. That's the
take your camera.
Bush chair.
All right, we have the T frame for his tarp.
Yep.
And it goes across. And there's another T frame, so when he puts his tarp, he has a good overhang.
Absolutely. Got that wide space up there.
Then I gave him a hammer.
Check that out. Yes, indeedy.
And this is just there, but he can hang pots here if he wants.
Freaking awesome.
he has a small table.
That's awesome.
Now, when he's cooking, he can just throw his pots right there when he's cooking and throw his pots. It's not heavy. I mean, it's not good. It's not heavy stuff. Just pots and pans and dishes right there. Then I built him his bush chair. Right here is a little piece of rope. He can hang a light, his pot, his drink, whatever he wants to put here. And he got his bush chair thingy dang. Now we're going to show him how to use his bush chair.
Here's the bush chair. Man, I got to tell you, I just don't know what to say, man. That's really, really nice of you, man. That is really super considerate and nice of you, man.
It's called teamwork, friendship.
That's right.
I can go on with the words.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm highly impressed with this.
I gave him a bush chair, but it's a homemade one. What you want to do is take off one sleeve. And this is a normal, this all is a what is this, Donnie?
Shower curtain.
Thank you. So what you have to do to use the bush chair, just put your shower curtain sleeve in here. See, Tom is going to make me a few of these.
He can do it too.
He can do it. He can make me a bush chair with no problem.
Gotta believe that.
And he's making it out of the camouflage colored material I have sent to him. Now, then you put this like so.
It just goes right through that sleeve where you got your curtain rods, huh?
Correct. Now, you have to give and take. This might be too low for you. You might have to move the legs around.
Pretty good to me. Really, truly, does.
It might have to get more string. I don't think this is long enough. Maybe you could put a carabiner here.
Okay.
All right, now, I'm going to be the guinea pig. I should make him be the guinea pig.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, out.
Yep. Yeah, more rope. Because, you want least.
It was slipping. I believe the material was slipping out. Believe it or not.
That's what it was. Yeah, it sure was. Well, let's fix that.
We could tie a knot behind the,
this time. Now, remember, you can use a, hammock. That's made with the see, during the summer, I don't use this during the summer. I use the cargo net or the hammock made out of cargo netting. All right, let's find out if I'm going to die or live to see the next day. That's how it's supposed to be.
All right.
Come take a test, Johnny.
Cool. I'm heavier than you.
I don't care. It should fit you.
All right, let's see. Let's see. I'll give the old college try one time.
Too tight? Now you remember you can move the legs back.
Yeah. No, actually it feels pretty good. Man, this is comfortable right here by the fire.
And now you can move that thing anywhere you want.
That's right. Man, this is nice. I'm gonna have to move it because it'll be right underneath my hand.
No, it won't be in your way.
Oh, it won't?
You know, you push your normal chair right there. I see your chair all there.
You're
all
right,
the time.
You're right, I do have a chair. Yeah.
So your chair is right there all the time. So you can't come and you will fit. Everything
good.
Will fit perfect.
Good. This is nice. Man, I can't thank you enough. Man, hey guys. Hey. What a nice thing to do, huh? I couldn't be happier. That is so freaking sweet. And you didn't mess my stick up.
I know what that was. That was your poke stick.
That's
I put
right.
it right there where you
that
belong.
My poking stick.
Come on. I know I'm a bushcrafter just like you, Donnie.
That's right. You know what it's about, man. Hell yeah.
Only thing I'm mad about him, what he did, he left that trash out here.
What
he
trash?
Left. He left those batteries. Those batteries need to be thrown away.
Well, that's a bonus. That's a senior moment, forgetfulness.
It's okay, Donnie.
These things are still good.
Well, this dude.
I was looking for them.
Oh, you probably lost them.
Yep. I'll be done. I wonder if they're still good.
Hey, you never know until you.
I'll try them.
Try them.
Heck yeah. All right.
Take a look at your table.
man. Yeah.
Now it's not really sturdy to put 1,000 pounds on it now.
I understand. That's all you need right there, man.
It's not the best, but hey, it's something for you to put your your pots.
I've got no negative criticism about it whatsoever. I think it's awesome. It's really nice and convenient because when you're out here working, I tell you, especially with an old fellow like me and my knees and stuff, having to do everything at the ground, it's a pain in the butt. I can put a seat or whatever, even this bush chair right here if I need to.
That's
everything
correct.
Be some kind of centrally located. I couldn't be happy. And this too. I really like that. Oh, there's your camera with me. God damn
it. It's all right. Whoa!
I don't know how to run that kind of machinery.
It's easier. Now that one's just up there now.
Yeah,
it's not there
you.
For
it's not for heavy stuff.
Yeah, it's just to hang one little item and you can take some your 550 card
right.
And make little loops and put your pans. Hang your pans, let them drip
heck
dry
yeah.
When they're clean.
Heck yeah, man. This is awesome, man. Thank you.
You're welcome. I
thank
hope you
so much.
Now we go watch and enjoy more of your bushcrafting videos.
That's right.
Right here.
Amen. I got a place, don't I?
You have a place.
Man, what a nice thing to do. That's why this community is what it is. It's special people. Good people. Friends. Real friends. Not no bullshit. Sorry about that word.
I'm no bullshitter. I'm a good friend. You can ask this man.
That's it. That's right. Man, I just don't know what to say, but thank you.
You're welcome.
I mean,
now, if you feel really guilty about it, just give me a spool of catfish string and I'm good.
Catfish string? I'll get you a catfish string. I can do that. I can do that. I sure can.
See, yeah, he
absolutely. Absolutely.
See where, you know, now he has more stretch like again.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Called the T-frame.
T-frame.
And I'll never see no other bushcrafters use
no.
The T-frame.
I haven't either. And it gives you so much more room under your tarp. It's just unbelievable. You figure instead of one ridge line where your tarp comes at an angle this way, you've got this flat area up here, flat area, and then your tarp starts angling off. So it gives you tons of headroom. And I'm underneath this thing right now with headroom to spare. That's comfortable. And when you're out here for a little while, you need it. When you're out here, you need a little comfort. I promise you. This is nice. This fills the bill. Okay? And that's all I got to say about that.
Your camera went off.
Oh, did it?
Yeah, just a few seconds. It's a low speed.
Okay.
That's all right.
Dang it. I need to do something with that card. Like you were saying, I need to get a new card.
It's still recording now.
Oh, is it?
You can always cut.
Yeah.
I don't cut nothing.
Yeah.
I don't edit any of my videos. The reason why... it's a pain in the ass. I do edit some of them.
Yeah,
but I hope you enjoy your new camping area.
I do enjoy my new camping area. Thank you, sir. I surely do. And so you want to take us out?
Let's take us out. Well, first you need your equipment. You can't leave that.
No, I can't. No.
Okay. All right, I take it down. Back up your camera some.
Yep.
Yeah. Now, this is just a simple... It was just a simple thing.
That boy had to bust me on the trash, didn't he? Couldn't let me go with losing a few batteries. I tell you what.
What the hell? I did that. I never knew. Okay, how'd that...
You're going to get a whooping.
Get your whoopings.
Man, I love the loop up there for the light because I use a light like that, you know?
Yeah, so... If you have a light, your pot, your whatever you want to, I know you can hold two, huh?
I can hold two. Sure can.
Now, that's all you have to do is pull that off. Pull your sleeve off the curtain, the shower curtain. Make sure you put your stick back on the rope to keep it from off the ground and rotten.
Very cool.
If you don't, this will rot.
That's right. I noticed you saved the bark off of it.
Oh yeah, because you gotta put your you don't want to rip your material, so you have to shave it. That's the only one you shave. Now later on, if you're bored, you're not busy,
yeah,
you can shave this off because
right.
This will tear you up by getting out So it's up to you later on, but I built it for you.
Man, I'm so happy about that. Man, I don't know what to say.
Now there's a stick back here, if you notice back here. Yeah. This will try to help it from going, you know, sliding away.
Yeah, so it don't kick out from underneath.
And the legs got slants. One slants this way, that'll slant that way. So it's a give and take. So, and remember, you can grab these two, pick them up, move it where you need.
Right.
I slept on this baby many, many times in my bush chair.
Yeah.
These things are comfortable. And if you make it for it, you can almost lay in the thing.
Oh, wow.
So I'm Ranger Kooky. I picked out Donnie Pantolini's
campsite.
Campsite.
Can't believe it. Yes, he did. He surely did. And I want to thank you, Ranger Kooky, for real. For real. I just couldn't be happier. And this is a total complete surprise, I can assure you. And, man, what can I say? Good friends. So, Ranger Kooky and Donnie Pavlini Outdoors, thank you guys for joining us for Ranger Kooky Pimp My Campsite. And we'll see you next time right here in the woods, that in the campsite that Ranger Kooky built. So, see you later.